All right, tubers. What's in the trunk? I got some stuff. I got another tripod. So let's see, I've got 6x9s for the deck lid there. And then 5x7s for the front doors. And then this box I got from my dad. Forgot to get out. It's got more loot in it. So I got a huge amp install kit. We'll go through that in a minute. And then we've got, I'm gonna try this one out. Precision Power. It was $150 for this. This runs the subwoofer. And it's a Peak 2000 watt altogether mono block amplifier, but at 4 ohms, which we'll be running, we got 700 watts. I think that's continuous, and that's quite a bit of power. I'm not going to be running that much, but that's what we're rated for on that. We could always upgrade this later. And then in the bag, got a couple of random things. I want to see what this is all about. I think this is for power, but well, we may use that. And I got an extra one of these, because I'll show you something else I'm going to be doing too. And then this is going to run the speakers. And I believe this has two inputs, so we're going to run front and rear on this so we can still have control over those. So we'll open this up in a minute. Cool, I like it. I do want to get some grills for it. That'll be later. But I ended up going with a Rockford Fosgate rear subwoofer. See, is it? I think it's just got one hookup. Cool. Wow. I think we'll have enough room. I'm probably gonna mount both amps on the box. Ooh wee. Well, let's open up some boxes. I can't wait to install this. I think one of the first things we'll probably work on is getting this set up. I still don't have my adapter or my mount kit for it. That's going to be tomorrow. So I think what we'll do is we'll get the wiring stuff dealt with. Get it, so all we got to do is plug her in and we're good to go. So this, I'll check this out in a second. I want to look at this amplifier. Ooh, man. Check this out. Man, it's getting cold out. My hands are freezing. Let's see. This has got a remote. So we'll need to route the wires for that guy. With see a couple of fuses, installation kit. Ooh la la. I think we're gonna run this bridged because there's only one input on that subwoofer. So there's an input and there is an output, so you could run this to your other amp, but I am going to be running four channels through the other amp, which we're gonna look at here in a second. Yeah, this is pretty typical. Someone's gonna yap at me about trunk space and stuff, and it's like, Well, that's what the trailer hitch is gonna be for. Let's look at this Blah Punk now. I've never bought one of these before. I know they're pretty good. I figured I'd go with an okay amplifier for the sub, but I think what really matters here is the meat and potatoes, which is their actual sound. So yeah, this is pretty cool. Okay, and this also comes with extra stuff as well. I was thinking originally mounting the sub and stuff to the trunk itself, but I'm going to leave it where it is. It doesn't move around and it grips the carpet pretty good in there. Now I want to leave it kind of floating there so that way if I have to, I can move it forward or something or take it out. Alright. The one place I went to get the speakers and the sub, I told the guy, yeah, I'll be back for the amplifiers. And totally went to a different place for amplifiers. Nice. Yep. Yep, two inputs. Sweet. So you know what I'll actually do is I'll do input, input, and then I could use the output to go to the sub. And that would kind of reduce the size of the harness.
Yeah, except that's not going to work out very well. You'll find out later.
That's cool. Yeah, you have a front, rear, perfect, yeah. I was thinking in my head, this is going to be like, oh, it's not going to be what I need. But I was looking at the box and go, I'm pretty sure it's going to have four inputs, or two inputs. I may utilize that, do a... you know, input, input, and then for the output, have it go right to the sub. So, don't really need to control the sub through the radio because that's what our remote's going to be for. So that will be pretty, pretty slick. All right, let's take a look at the speakers. I actually got to listen to these in the store and they sounded really good. So I was like, yeah, I'll take a box. And I don't even know how much these were. I kind of just bought them.
Might need those.
So these are the 5x7s that will go in the doors. Do we get any stickers? Nope. No grills. I'm not worried about having grills because they're going to be hidden behind the doors anyways. See, it feels like metal. Yeah. So we'll probably... driver's side mount it like this so the tweeter's facing. Oh, but you can aim the tweeter wherever you want. That's pretty cool. So you can just put it in there and do whatever. I'm probably gonna have it something like that. If you look in here, this is an important part in speakers. These aren't gonna see a whole lot of bass, but you see the wires down in there, the leads. You really want these to be attached to a part of the spider in here, because otherwise it will actually, this whole length of wire will vibrate even more so and will break off in here, or even worse, just break off right in there. And she's done. Oh man, let's check these out. These come with grills, but like I mentioned, they're gonna be hidden, so I don't care about the grills. Smells like a speaker. Cool. And these have a pretty good amount of excursion. Seem like pretty good. So it's got an interesting coating on the front. I don't know what kind of coating, but it feels like it's some kind of paper cone, but it has a coating on the outside. Rubber surround. You know, that's fine with me. But hey, they sounded really good.
Cool.
And of course we got our yeller top. It's gonna run our power to our amplifiers. Yeah, it just breaks into a million pieces. Come on now. Wow, it just... Are you for real? Okay, we got that. This is actually the perfect right length ground wire. Get out of there, Jesus Christ. It's a fairly new kit, and this shit doesn't want to come apart. Yay, any big cuts anywhere yet? So my thought with this was to... Oh, I know what I forgot to get. We'll have to install one later. I forgot to get a capacitor. I'm surprised the guy that I got the subwoofer from didn't say anything about that. So... Well, this little guy... You can screw down somewhere. So, what I'm thinking is I would like to, maybe we'll have this go to the battery. We can screw this or even sticky tape it to the car somewhere. And then we'll run our length. And then what this will do is this will mount on the box and we'll have one wire go up. We'll have one wire go up, and then we can run one wire to our subwoofer and another to, or the subwoofer amplifier and another to the thing. Yeah, because I think we'll have plenty of thick wire. Now, the only thing I don't know is will... You know, I was thinking about... Oh, I think I got it somewhere. I think I have extra wire that'll be enough for both amps, but what I want to do is I want to have one come off of here, go to the subwoofer amp, and then another one go to the thing, and then we'll have this big lead, which will take the power to run both those amps. And I'm, you know, I have to look into it, but I'm thinking we could probably, well, no, we want that in line, so. Eventually, this will actually go to a capacitor, and then from the capacitor, we'll go to our subwoofer amplifier. But I'm going to look into that and make sure I have that idea right. But so I may get another one of these for the ground. I should have bought two of these while I was at Fry's. I may run out there again and pick up another one or even see if I can order one. This is the most annoying fucking thing ever. I'm so glad that guy's moving. It's like, let me just rev the piss out of this constantly, just all the time, just... All right, for this bit, we're gonna need a voltmeter or even a test light will work. So here is our mutilated wiring harness. This bit here, I think this is all the speakers and steering wheel control stuff. We don't need that because we're bypassing all that.
I am not getting the pack kit for the steering wheel control for the radio and stuff. I don't necessarily care for that a whole lot. It would be cool, but not really justifying the extra expense of the unit, so I passed on it. However, you know, this stuff, everything else still works, so that's all that matters. I don't care about the radio control. So anyways, we have three wires here. This is our ground. Excuse me. And then this is the, one of these is a constant. I think it was the green was a constant, and then this was a key on. We can check that with the voltmeter. I'll have to strip these back. And then the other wire we're going to need out of this, I'll have to check out the voltmeter, but I think it's, let's see which one it is. I thought it was this blue one, blue and purple was the illumination. And so that way when you put your headlights on, the screen will dim down and it won't be blinding you. Have never done that in any of the rigs. And now I'm like, yeah, I should probably do that. And so our illumination wire is, I think it's this orange one here. So then, there's a few things on here. Interesting things. We have, you know, your basic power. You know, this is key on. Actually, I think this is key on. This is power. And then, so you also have a couple of different inputs. Now, I don't have a backup camera yet to install, so this part I'm going to worry about later. So you have reverse, and so when you put it in reverse, it will turn on. It will turn on the backup camera. But I may actually put this on a switch so I can control it manually. And then the rest of these wires are just for the the amplifier. And I just blanked tubes. So I'll be back in just a second. I'll tell you, I'll verify with you guys about this wire here. And then I'm also going to fish some wires, or the two. See, there should be an opening. Yeah, right here, right in the back. I don't know if you guys see it. Oh, wait. So you see right there, I'm going to throw my cables down there and it should drop down. Oops. Should drop down and come back behind all that HVAC stuff. How you like that night shot, huh? Pretty neat, huh? All right, tubes. So I've got illumination, which is soldered into that like blue and turquoise or whatever, purple wire. So that works. Well, I actually have to test that part. But I did verify that that's the illumination wire because it gets 12 volts when you put the headlights on. Then there's this guy, the ground, hooked up, soldered in. We've got that wire right there. It's white and blue. That's the key on, our constant. As you can tell, I forgot my heat shrinking there, so I had to put some tape on that. A little annoyed there. And then, so the green and black is the constant, verify with voltmeter, and then we got our turn on wire routed. And this is a temporary routing. I'm actually going to try and run them underneath the carpet back there, and I'm kind of trying to get these stupid pillar thing or trim pieces out. These things are anchored pretty good, so I'm going to try and figure out how to get those out without killing them, because I like to just run it along, you know, the back and then go to the trunk and figure everything out from there. So the only thing I've got unused is the reverse wire. We'll deal with that later when I get a backup camera. And then I've got this is the parking brake switch, but I don't think we really need that. And then these are all the speaker wires. They're cut and staggered and then folded over and then double heat shrink, so those are closed off. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get my electrical tape and I'm going to loom this all up
so that it's a nice clean loom. Temporary plug these in, and I don't really care about that so much just yet. And I'm going to lay this right here. I don't have the bracket yet, and we still have to, I'm going to borrow the neighbor's Dremel again because I still haven't bought one, and I'm going to just trim this out. This has to go in order to get the radio in. The mounting kit clicks into the sides here, so we need those. But up here, we do not. So when we get to the installation kit, we'll get to that part later. So now I'm going to take care of that, get these plugged in. I'm going to route my cables to the truck and start working on hooking up the amps for initial testing. And then as long as everything else there works good, then I can mount the amps to the box and start, I can't really run any power wires just yet. I can't quite get everything done yet because we still have to deal with getting the battery mounted in the back. We have to get cables for the battery routed to the front. The front battery. I still need to get my relay, and I still have some battery terminal stuff I need to order. So I have a few things left to get. So I'll end up taking care of that later. I'll probably get some stuff in order tonight, and then that way when it comes up, we can finish installing all that. Tubes, we're going for the front page of Sloppy Mechanics. Okay, this is just temporary setup. I just wanted to make sure all the amps and stuff work. I still haven't gotten that one hooked up to speakers yet. I'm about ready to kill the whole gig here and go in for the next. Oh, I am freezing. But I just wanted to look at my gain here. Not even like trying. What is this thing doing? Is it even like hooked up to my phone all the way? Oh, Jesus Christ. I wanted to see something here. I think I'm gonna get another aux cable, or not aux, but another one of these. Also run it to the back for the sub itself, because the output on the other amp looks like it's a, Yeah, see if I just go to the front. So it's split it down to mono, so that's good. Okay, so what I will do is, I don't know if that cable's on. I'm just gonna get another one of these. Go to the stereo shop tomorrow, get another one of these. And I will run that from the sub output on this to the amp back there. So yeah. Might hook up some speakers real quick here just so I can hear the amp. Well, tubes, that's gonna be it for today. It's freezing cold in here. Next time we come back, I'm going to work on getting all the wiring done on in the trunk. Probably going to install the speakers before doing that, get that out of the way, and then after that, get into the meat and potatoes of the rear, the wiring in the trunk. That's gonna be a lot of fun. So, anyways, I have some parts I need to order, so I'm gonna get online, do that, and then, we'll catch you next time. See you guys later.